how do you feel about leaving Phantom? Is it like bittersweet or?
It's bittersweet. It's bittersweet. I do. I'm going to miss the music. I'm going to miss the people. I made some amazing friends, you know, and friends that, you know, I never knew Josh before, but he is something like, you know, just one of those people you just know you're going to be friends with, you know, forever. And that made, that's sad for me because, you know, I was kind of hoping for 6 more months of sharing that, that amazing thing that we were doing together, you know, as another Aussie. And, yeah, always I'm prepared. I was prepared for it mentally to do my last show because that is a huge occasion. You know, I would have done like, I think in total, I worked it out. It was going to be 14,000 top C's. For any opera singer to understand how much that is, that's a lot, you know. That's a huge part of your life. I was able to buy my house with that show, you know. And, yeah, it becomes a part of your life, doesn't it? I only met my boyfriend when I was in that show, so we knew nothing else apart from that life. So, yeah, you're right. It is bittersweet. I'm okay because it's good for my mental health that I can spend time with my partner and work on myself a little bit more, which sometimes is difficult in a show 8 times a week. But I'm also going to be sad that I'm never going to be able to stand on that stage for at least the next year and a half or whenever it is till it gets fixed and possibly not share it with those amazing people that I was sharing it with.
Are you going to miss anything about Piangi?
Yeah, I am. I love him. I mean,
oh, he's such a schmuck.
What was that?
He's such a schmuck.
He is a schmuck, you know. And, you know, I'm not going to miss having to chase a soprano around the stage my whole life. But, you know, I love him. And I really worked on that character a lot, you know. In general, Piangi is a very small role, but I was given a lot of liberties by the creative teams in the London production. Yeah. And I was able to do a lot more things than anyone else before, which was such a blessing because you could easily be very bored in such a small role.
What types of things were you able to do?
Oh, a lot of extra things like, you know, comedic moments mostly. I was given like a good ability to be able to do like extra comedic things. And I mean, you saw it a million times, like it was never always the same. Like I always did, like I always took a risk differently every night to make it that little bit more funny. And, you know, I got into trouble a lot because, you know, I would would do things that are just too far, you know, and I'd be like, no, Paul, that's a no, you know, but everyone just laughs it off and goes, okay, what's next?
You know? I must admit, I'd never really noticed Piangi before as a character until I saw you playing him. And then I was like, wow, there's a whole other character in the musical that I'd never even really took time to watch. But yeah.
I mean, I was lucky for that, you know. But, you know, I don't know if I would have felt comfortable. You know, I always was told that a role is only as small as the actor in it, you know. So, I mean, I don't think I could have been any more big, you know, at some points. But it was a great time. I had such a good time and fun time with him. He always made me happy, even when I was sad off stage. Being him on stage always made me feel better, you know? So I'll miss that.
And is your future musical theatre, solo? What do you kind of, optimally, what would you like to do?
I'm doing, like, obviously concerts. I love concert work. Absolutely adore that. Opera is definitely something I'm not going to give up. You know, I think I had a great break from that world now, and I'm ready to probably try again in that field. I've been asked to do some workshops already for a new musical. It's based in Belgium, so yeah, it's like Othello. It's like a musical of the Shakespeare. So yeah, and the music's like beautiful. I mean, like you just never know what's going to come up, you know. And my focus is on teaching for now because it gives me joy. These kids work really hard.
Doesn't teaching though worry you because you're teaching what are these really optimistic kids hoping to follow in footsteps of your own, say, but we don't even know if the future there is viable for them. I mean, what is your advice to the kids you're teaching about the world they might be entering into?
Yeah, you are exactly right in saying that. So I don't just teach, you know, I am working, and that is something that really is like, doesn't really happen these days, you know? So I know exactly what you're saying. And I thought to myself at the beginning of this, before it even really got real for us, you know, when we lost our jobs and whatnot, I thought to myself, I have 25 kids who are always dedicated. They are working so hard, and now they're at home, they're working even more hard. I'm going to do something for them to help them with their careers, you know? So I put like I raised some money online. I think I raised like $1,000, you know, in the first attempt to raise some money for supporting young artists, because I said the exact same thing. Netflix and music and everything, they are all artists and they all have to start somewhere. You don't want to lose a generation just because of this epidemic. So I raised all this money. In 1 week, I raised 1,000. I was a little bit shocked. Then I thought, what am I going to do with it? So I started organizing masterclasses with the best casting directors of West End, some of the best vocalists, you know, teachers. And I got Paul Wooler, who was the head of Habit of Cameron McIntosh, Felicity French, who's a casting director, an agent, Michelle Blair, and all of these people came together and offered these workshops for these young singers. So yes, they've been working hard, you know, but they have also now done something that would usually take an artist 5 years to do as a professional, sing for these casting directors.
Yeah.
And also be able to sing and start applying for agencies, because yes, here in the UK specifically, things are not looking good. But the rest of the world, things are looking good. And even some of them are starting to learn German because they know where the future is.
Interesting. Interesting.
You know, so that is how we are adapting and become and just following that resilience that we have inside of us as actors.
Do you find it a bit of a paradox that during the lockdown, the first thing we all did was rush online to watch the creatives and the arts industry? You know, we watched so many box sets, we watched concerts that were put on YouTube. Andrew Lloyd Webber himself put loads and loads of his own concerts for a couple of days up for live streaming. The Royal Albert Hall did the same, and they were very, very well watched. But yet, when it actually comes to the crunch time, there's been little financial support for the arts, which so many have relied upon during lockdown.
Yeah, you're exactly right with that. You know, in regards to Andrew, I was in the movie Love Never Dies, so I received a royalty from one of those. So, you know, just let's be clear with that specifically. Those artists that were involved in my production, because it was an Australian production, we were looked after, it was under contract, it was paid in royalties, so we're very lucky. But on that discussion, the fact that we haven't received any specific financial support here or in Australia is something to be discussed, because you are exactly right. We go straight to music whenever we feel upset or sad or depressed or anxious. It is our own way that we use music to help ourselves. Watching TV for that distraction after a long day of hard work in the office. Listening to the radio on your way to school, on your way on the tube. How many people in the tube in London with their earphones in listening to that music? It is only because of us that we are able to survive times like this. You know, and if we had none of that, I can assure you this world would be a very different place. So why aren't we given a focus, a priority?
Yeah.
You know, and that is a absolutely important question that we should be asking.